everyone, it's Tammy, and it's time for another Plan With Me video. My book is getting awfully thick, if you can see that. But this is a Kiki K binder, and inside it, I have my plum paper family planner. My plum paper family planner, woo! and this week that we're currently on is my Fox Week, which I just think is turning out really, really cute. And it's actually early. I am videoing this on Friday so that I can get this posted over the weekend. And then I'm going to be planning, not for that week, but for the 21st through the 27th. So I'm going to take these pages out because it's just easier to use the everything when it's out. And whoops, I guess I didn't need to close that, did I? And I'm going to put my planner to the side. And we will get started on this week. And this is an exciting week because if you remember from last week, the 26th is homecoming. And the 25th and 26th is also something called James Dean Days. The 25th is also my husband's aunt's birthday. The 26th would have been my father's birthday. He would have been 75 this year, which is just amazing. No, I think 74, actually. Let me think for a second. Nope, 75 this year. So that's crazy. He passed away in 1998. December 22nd. That was a very hard Christmas, but I think about him every day and I love my daddy. So anyway, we have lots of planning to do and it's going to be fun. And guess what I got? Woohoo! A new whiteout. I know you guys probably aren't as happy as I am about that, and I'm not even sure how to use this one. Does it go this way? I guess it has to go this way. I don't even know how to use it. That's so funny. All right, well, maybe I'm excited over nothing because I don't know how to use this thing and it's not doing anything. What in the world? I might have to get my daughter to help me figure out this whiteout. Seems like it would go this way, but nothing seems to be happening. You have to be smarter than the whiteout. I was so excited about getting this too because my other ones, it's horrible. Surely you don't go that way, do you? Oh no, now I'm ruining in the paper. Well, I guess I can pull it out to see. Okay, so it does come out. Oh my goodness, it looks like it does come out on this side. That just doesn't seem right to me. Oh, now I've kind of screwed it up. Leave it to me to mess up a whiteout. I'm trying to see if I can open it. It feels like it opens, but maybe it's not meant to open. Oh my goodness. Well, now I'm just making it worse. Holy shimoly, this is just insane. I am sorry, guys. You have to be smarter than the whiteout to use it, and apparently I'm not. Oh, it looks like it wants to open so badly. And I think I'm just gonna break it. But maybe that's okay because it's no good this way, is it? I can't use it like this. Holy cow. Okay, let me use the scissors. And let's just open this bad boy. And goodness gracious, you know my videos are long anyway, so I apologize for taking up some of our time with something so silly. Man, oh man. Whew. Yeah, I broke it. There's a piece right there. But this is crazy. So, this is crazy, crazy. I have never seen whiteout like this. No, Something's not right. Okay, so I want it to be pulled. That way. So I need to wind up. Holy cow, this is crazy. So this needs to go over here. This used portion. My goodness, I was all excited about getting new white out, and now I just keep trashing it even more. Oh, goodness. Okay, here we go. Let's do this. Did it go between those two? And then it went over. And then I don't really know how it gets down into the thing. Maybe like this. I just need to wind this part. Oh, and you can't just wind that part? Oh my goodness. Okay, well, let's see what I can do here with just this. I have no idea. Well, that didn't work. Well, that's not working. Dag nabbit, this is a mess and a half. I feel like I'm just wasting everybody's time. Okay, I'm just throwing this away. This is crap. Stupid whiteout. Alright, so much for that. Let's go back to this crappy whiteout. My goodness. But at least this whiteout doesn't go nuts. I'm sure I just messed that up somehow, which I don't exactly know how, but you know. And see, this doesn't even work. How can white out be so stupid? I'm losing my cool, guys. I'm losing it. Work is crazy for me right now. So I want to come home and I want to plan and I just want to have some fun and do what I like to do and not be hassled by silly whiteout that doesn't want to white out anything. And look, okay, so I put it there. Oh, and look, it just comes off when I rub it. Much less when I try to do this. Isn't that lovely? That's just great, isn't it? That just looks wonderful. Thank you, whiteout. Ugh. Why am I even doing this? I will just use something that won't even, you can't see through it, because I'm just sick of it. All right, let's just pretend we're starting again. You know what? Maybe I will start again, because that's just a mess. But then again, maybe you guys like to see the real, so I'm just going to leave it, because it's real. It's real. It is real. The struggle is real. So here we are. Let's just start with some washi, shall we? And let's see, my colors are going to be based on this cute turtle page that I just love. So it's I'm turtly awesome, try to be like a turtle, comfortable in your own shell. And I didn't cut any of these out yet, so this is going to be just a very long video, and I apologize now. I will try to hurry. And let's see, I think I'm going to go for the green and the pink glittery washi. So the pink is already opened, of course, because I love pink. And the green is getting open now. Of course, I just got the green, so I did a haul on all of my washi, I think. And I have two birthdays this week. I think I just said that. And it's just going to be a fun week. So let's go with some green washi, if I can find where it opens. There it is. And I'm going to cut it so it's smaller. Smaller, smaller, smaller. So I hope you guys are having a good week. One of my friends is doing a Jamberry online show, and I don't know exactly how that works, but I'm kind of interested in it. I am loving the Jamberry nails. I don't know if you guys have seen it or heard of it or know what the heck I'm talking about, but it is nail like decals, and I have some fake Jamberries on now, my cute zebras. They are not real Jamberry, but they're like from Claire's or something, and I'd had them forever, and I had some Jamberries on that I got as a sample, and I tried them and liked them, but then this morning I noticed they were kind of peeling off, so I thought, ooh, I have these, I'll use these. I've had these forever. These certainly are not as good as the Jamberry because I can already see them peeling up a little bit, but I don't care. It's not like I'm doing this like I'm some hand model or something, because Lord knows I'm not. So it's fine, but it was just really convenient that one of my friends is happened to have an online Jamberry party, and I don't know how this is going to work, but it's like a mystery hostess, so I guess my chances of being the hostess with the mostest without having to do anything are just as good as everybody else's. And if you win that, then you get free product, or you get to take whatever the free product was for the party. So I'm kind of excited about that a little bit. I think that might be just fun. And what did I do with this? There it is. So I'm kind of excited. I looked through their catalog and there is tons of good looking stuff. So that makes me happy. And I like to do the French manicure a lot, and they actually have a French manicure, which actually looks halfway decent. Sometimes I'm afraid to use the French manicures, like fake nails and stuff, because it just looks silly. But this one actually looks halfway decent, and if it works, I'm gonna be happy about that. So, and they have a special, I don't know if they have it all the time, but it's buy three, get one free, or yeah, I think that's right. And each one is $15, which kind of seems a little pricey, but then when you learn, at least this is what they told me, at least this is how I understood it. One set covers two manicures and a pedicure. So if that's true, then I'm not so worried about it, because that's a pretty good deal. But then I heard from somebody that said, no, that's not right. It only does two manicures. So I don't know. Either way, I mean, even with two manicures, that's still not a bad price for $15. But it's not like a manicure that you're getting somewhere else, let's face it, because I'd still be doing it, and that means it's not going to be as good as if I went to the nail salon. But it's easier and it doesn't take as long, and I'm doing it at home, so there's some good things about it too, and I think it will be fun. So, and you get to pick, you know, fun little designs, which I don't do at the nail salon. At the nail salon, I just usually get my French manicure or a color and call it a day. And I kind of like the idea of just having one highlight nail. Like right now my other nails are just plain, and then I have the zebra on my ring fingernail. And there was a woman that I used to work with in one of my past jobs. I was a nuclear medicine technologist, and there was another woman who worked there, and she would always, well, I think it was about always, she would, she liked the French manicures also, and she would get a little crystal, like rhinestone, on her ring fingernail, and I just thought she was so classy. She was younger than me, and she was just cute as a button. She's still awesome. So, Jamie, if you're watching this, hello. I still think you're awesome. But I don't know. I don't know if she still does that or not, but that's what kind of got me started, and this is not sticking to this nastiness. Oh, my goodness. The struggle is real, guys. I am not even kidding. This whiteout is the death of me. Okay, let's just peel this off and let's get that crap off there. Look how easy that was to get off. Now, I don't know if this will stick again or not. I'm going to try it, but if not, I will just get a new piece. Yeah, I'm just going to get a new piece because I think I still have one. Yes, I do. So, ever since I knew Jamie, I would, not always, but I would lots of times get something just on my ring finger because I just thought it was really cute. And she was the influence for that. So I still kind of do that with just doing a decorative nail. Ooh, and this ring I made, isn't that lovely? I'm actually going to put a DIY on that sometime, maybe near Christmas. It's a lot easier to make than you might think. But if you don't want to make it, I do have them available on my shop. If you go to Etsy and type in TP Treasures, you will find us. My sister-in-law, Jeanette, and I, we opened a store. And it seems to be doing pretty well so far. Of course, we've only been open for a week. But it's fun. And it gives me a reason to make more jewelry and wear lots of jewelry, which doesn't make me upset at all. I'm going to cut this pink one too. So what I like to do in my planner, for those of you that are new to my channel, or if I just haven't said it when you were listening before, because I get it, I sometimes just have a channel on and I watch, but I'm halfway listening and halfway doing something else. And I know my videos are long, so I don't blame you one bit. But what I like to do is I like to cover up, and this took me a while to get to the point where I'm at, and I don't know if this is planner piece or whatever they call it, but I do enjoy how I'm doing it right now. But I cover up the names, even though I have the family planner where I could customize what's on the side, and I liked to do that, and I did that. And I just realized that not everything that I put on there really needs its own box. So I'm thinking I might order the same family planner next time, but if I do, I'm not going to get the same things down the side. I'm going to leave more blank so that I have more to just fill in however I want. But then also, I cover up this sometimes just because I think it's pretty, and then I'll cover up the sides here in just a little minute. And then what I'm doing now is I like to divide up some spots for my husband and my kids, because I used to give them each their own box. So there was a box for Dennis, a box for Katie, a box for Alex. And although I like that, it was a little unnecessary because because they didn't always need their own box. Because, you know, we're all busy, but they don't do things every day. And, you know, like if they're doing chores or something, I could just write that on, you know, the regular, like it's time to vacuum or whatever. I don't keep track of who did it because I don't really care as long as it gets done. And we all kind of pitch in mostly to get the job done. Now, I think I might do one pink and one green just to kind of make it crazy. Or no, because I'll have two of these. I think I'll just do pink. Because if I cut this in half, of course I can't find the end again. This glittery is hard to find the end sometimes. There it is, there it is. Okay, so, oh, I have a little piece. I don't know how that happened. Oh, now I can't get it off my finger. Oh gosh, and the cat got into my bag of trash and took the white out, and now it's all over the floor. All sprawled out. Thank you, Jambo. And he's crawling up the other side. These cats, as soon as I turn on the camera, they like are excited. I don't know what it is about them. Fuzzy is taking a nap with my husband, and Jambo is being nuts. Crazy kitties. So then I just put this down here to make it party, party, party. I don't know about you guys, but I think that this year is going by so incredibly fast. It's absolutely ridiculous. I'm trying to get my Christmas shopping done, and I know it's early, but I'd really, I think I've mentioned this before, but I'd really like to have everything done and wrapped before Thanksgiving so that I can enjoy the holidays without the stress of presents and spending money and figuring out what people want. So I don't know. I'm going to Chicago in at the end of November through the early part of December. I have a business trip, but I do get to do some shopping too. So that's always hard because my daughter's birthday is November 29th, and then also with Christmas, you know, when you're in Chicago, you want to buy stuff. So I might save just a couple things to know that I can get down there and then have everything else already done. Now I have done a little bit of wrapping, so that's good. I think I even did a video. Oh, I don't think I have yet. I think that's on my plans to do a video of wrapping. I know I haven't done it yet. But I will do a little bit of one, because I'm doing wrapping a little differently this year than usual. I usually just, you know, wrap in wrapping paper or whatever, and I'm still doing that, of course. It's not like I'm using washi tape to wrap or anything this year. What a pain that would be. Although I might use washi tape to, like, decorate the package a little bit. But I'm trying to do, like, brown paper packages tied up in bows. That's kind of my, tied up with string, that's like my theme this year, is I'm using brown paper packaging, and I'm using some Christmas twine and decorating. And this year also I have some nice jewelry gifts to give away, because, you know, with our store, we thought it would be cool to give some gifts away like that. And I think that, I hope that people like it. I like it. I mean, what woman doesn't want a necklace or a pair of earrings or something, you know? Okay. So that's the baseline washi, and before I put any other washi down, I'm going to put some boxes down, and I'm going to take this and I'm going to use this to cut my little guys. Actually, you know what, I think I'm going to use my other paper trimmer, because this one doesn't cut as well as this one does, where I can see where it is with this wire. So I'm going to use this, and I'm sorry that I didn't do this prior, so I will just talk to you guys. I have a silhouette, and I should be able to use my silhouette to cut these out, but I haven't ever tried, and I don't know how to do that. So I have that on my list of things to do, but I don't have like a time frame on it. It's just things I know I'd like to do to figure out how to use the silhouette to actually cut these out, so then I don't have to. But there's a few reasons why my silhouette isn't as convenient as it should be. One of them is just the fact that my computer upstairs doesn't really work, and I have a new workstation that I need to put down or use instead. I just haven't had the, it hasn't been a necessity, and I haven't made a priority, so I haven't done that yet. And then also, I'm going to be, when my daughter goes away to college, I'm going to be moving all of my scrapbooking stuff and all of my crafty stuff downstairs into what is currently her dance room. And I'm excited about that in one way because I have a nice room and it'll be all clean and nice and all that. But in another way, I'm not, because that means that my chicken is gone. I'm going to miss her tremendously. I cannot tell you how much I'm going to miss that girl. She is my love. And my frog band too, my owl. They're just good kids. But this is part of life, isn't it? This is what I want them to do. Of course, Alex still has 2 more years, but with him living with his dad, it's a little different. I'm so proud of both of them. But so my daughter just applied to her college that she thinks she would like to go to, her number one choice. So hopefully she'll find out if she gets early acceptance into there or not, and then we can start making some bigger plans. Of course, I've already started getting some stuff, and I'll do some hauls on my channel probably over the summer next year so that we can show everybody what we found and all that good stuff. I am a planner, so I enjoy that a lot, and it's really nice for me to go ahead and know what I'm gonna need and all of that. So the sooner she decides for me, the better. But I mean, I'm not trying to rush her. This is a big decision, I know, and it's her decision to make. And so I am trying not to influence her. I told her that I wouldn't mention much unless she asks me or unless I think she's making a poor decision. I told her I would not let her do something absolutely ridiculous. Like, I'm not going to let her major in, I don't know, something that I don't think that she could get a good degree in. She's not going to major in underwater basket weaving and get out of school and expect to get a job. So she wants to travel. That's her main focus, is traveling and making a difference, and I think that's awesome. So hopefully she'll make enough money so that she can do that pretty effortlessly, which is the goal. And these already have stick on them because these I printed on sticker paper. So I am trying to use those. The only problem with these are that when I print them on the printer, they don't seem to pick up as much color with the sticker paper. And I've tried a few brands of sticker paper and I keep having the same problem. So if you guys know of any secrets that has like a really good brand, this Digi Orange or Orange Digi, I don't know what it's called, but Digi Orange, I think, it seems to be the best so far, but clearly it's still not great. And I'm looking for something fabulous, because after all, we are totally awesome. Well, seriously, when you spend money on stuff, you want it to work right. Right. Okay. So, we had a place called Mark Pies for dinner, and it's like Japanese food, but it's kind of like carry out, but it's, I mean, we carry it out, but it's a little nicer than like Chinese carry out or whatever, and it's so good. But I ordered this, I just had shrimp pad thai, and sometimes they make it super spicy and other times it's fine, and this time it was one of those times when it's super spicy and my mouth is still kind of on fire. It's crazy. Okay, I've cut a lot of these. I'm almost done. I don't think I'll cut the other ones unless I need them, so that I won't bore you guys to death while I'm cutting. But let's see. I know I want one of these weekly spending pages. Ugh, I think I want one of these. I really don't, but I might need one, so I'm gonna go for it, even though I really don't want to track my spending. But it would be a good idea. And who doesn't need to budget? Everybody needs a budget. And these I got from somebody online. Somebody made them, and She was giving them away. I think it was on a Facebook group. I don't even remember. And honestly, they're not the best. I mean, see how they're kind of like written over, but it'll work. And I didn't have to do it, so it's even better. And let's see, I have some other cute things here. And then I also have these that I can cut out. Okay, I'm not going to cut these out unless I need them, I guess. Okay, so let's get rid of these. Of these trash. These trash. It's trash. Oh, whoops, that's not trash, is it? I don't know if I want these or not, but oh, I probably do want some of them anyway. I'll just snip these with my scissors. I won't cut them all out. I'm gonna have those round guys too, but I honestly don't use those too much, so I'll just leave those cut, and if I decide I want to use one, I'll just cut it. I'll leave them uncut. And I'm not going to cut out all these. I'm just going to cut out the ones that have the turtles on them. Because after all, those are my favorite. Gosh, we're 31 minutes in already. I'm sorry, guys. I'm feeling pressure. I don't know why my plan with me's are so much longer than other people's. I don't feel like I'm a big, huge talker, but maybe I am. Okay, I need a drink for sure. Okay. Now, I did take off a lot of my stickers already, like my actual planning stickers. So we got that going for us. Today, this says, and of course there's no easy way to peel this backing off. Oh, but it's not so bad. Let's put this one here on Saturday, because actually, you know what, I think I'm going to put it on Friday. Or which day? Because I know I need to pick up the... Well, that's okay. I'll put it on Friday. And this will kind of give me a hint of stuff that I have to do all weekend. And this, I think I'm taking Friday off. I'm not sure yet. My husband is taking that day off, but he hasn't really mentioned whether or not he wanted me to take it off so that we could go James Dean days together, or if he wants to take it off and sleep in and then we can go to James Dean days later. I don't know, because I don't want to take a day off if he's just going to sleep. So we will see. I'm going to put this on Monday, because who doesn't need to feel totally awesome on a Monday? I know I do. And these are little half boxes, but for me these are full boxes. And they're just cute as can be. This one has little turtles all over it. It's kind of hard to see though. But it's cute. And I will ask permission if I have... if I can post where I got these online, because I'm just not sure if the woman wants recognition or not for doing all of these, but I will tell you that she's awesome. And I think that I can, but I kind of asked her before and I don't really know that she answered me. And I remember thinking, oh, okay, maybe I'm messing up. Maybe I'm not supposed to. So I will ask her like more bluntly this time. Because it certainly could have just been the way I asked. Where are some of the full boxes? Here they are. These are just so stinking cute. I love turtles. I used to call my son Turtle. Actually, sometimes I'd even call my daughter Turtle, because just the way their lips looked. And Katie is definitely a chicken, my daughter. But my son sometimes Turtle. Sometimes. So because I plan my planner this way, I really need to look at the different ways that they have the plum paper planner this year. Because maybe a different planner, not a different brand, but a different format would be better for me. I'm really not sure. And then, on the other hand, I still like doing the washi and such because I think it's just pretty. So I guess my question to myself is, would I change it even if I had a different view? Like if I had just had the three boxes like the Erin Condren has, or however many boxes they have, it might be four. If I had that, would I still put my washi on the same way, or would I do it differently? And if my answer is that I do it the same, then I don't really know if I need to change it. Know what I mean? La la la. I just love these turtles. I'm so excited for my son on the 26th. Like I've mentioned, he's going to homecoming. So we have a lot to do between now and then, because he lives with my ex, but my ex hasn't done anything as far as I know with like getting a suit for him. So we need to figure that out. And I'm really not sure if we want to rent a suit, if that's even something that people do nowadays, or if we want to purchase a suit, because he is 16 almost. So you know he's going to be growing a lot still. And I almost hate to waste the money on a suit that's not going to fit him in 3 months. So I'm kind of leaning toward renting one, but if we're going to rent one, we need to get going on that. And then I know he's going with some friends. So if he's doing that, then we also need to work on like what they're doing for dinner and all of that jazz. And I don't think that my ex thinks about that stuff. I think that he just, you know, thinks it's all going to be taken care of, because it usually was. I did order a corsage for her because I knew that that would be overlooked. So I thought, well, I'll go ahead and order that. So I know that that's coming. Or not coming, but we have to pick it up. And then I know one of his friend's moms had said that they were going to order food and have a little party in their backyard, but I just want to make sure that that's the truth and that's really what's happening, because I haven't talked to the mom. I just talked to the friend who said that that's what his mom said. So I need to take that initiative. If he's not going to, I need to figure out what is going on, because I don't want my son to be in the dark any more than he already is at 15 years old, almost 16. He'll be 16 on the 4th. You know, the boy is brain damaged. What can I say? There's a song called Renegade, and I think you guys have probably heard it, but I don't want to sing it because, one, I don't know all the words, and two, I know that there's some copyright rule, so I don't want to screw that up, but I have it in my head, and it's horrible because I don't know the words, so I'm just kind of halfway singing it, hey, 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 like that, and it's ridiculous. There. There's more turtles on this page than I thought there were. More boxes and such. People say things of that nature a lot lately. Have you noticed that, or is that just around here in the Midwest? Like, you'll be having a conversation with someone and they'll say, yeah, that works with this and things of that nature. And I don't know, I'm just like, what? Where did that come from all the time? I'm not a big fan. Let's see. I cannot believe that my dad would be 75. I'm still not sure if that's right. Because he was 30 years older than me. And I am 44. So, maybe he... Okay, no, that is right. He would be turning 75 because he was... Yes, he was 30 when I was born. That makes sense. And I was born in March, so... Time flies. I'm still thinking in my head, 75. Whew. That's kind of getting up there. That is kind of. Are so cute, and I love the pink and green together. And I was not going to use this layout. I was going to do pink and gold, or I still have a few other ideas in my mind for September that I wanted to do. And when Alex said that he was, well, wanted to go to homecoming, and when I realized that it was this week, I thought, you know what, I really want to do something cute on the 26th. And their school colors are red, black, and white. Not that that matters, but that's also happens to be the colors that they're wearing. Like, she has a black and white dress, and she's going to be wearing red shoes, and her corsage is going to be little mini roses. And my son is wearing a pair of black pants with a white shirt and a red bow tie. Bow ties, I think that's hilarious. So... when I was thinking of the pink and gold, I thought, no, I want to do something that I can put the red in. So, of course, I do the pink and green because, you know, you can put red with that. It probably would look better with the pink and gold. Oh, well. My mind doesn't work right all the time. Oh, here we go. So, my nails are still bad. If you guys have been watching me or following me, you know that I used to wear acrylics all the time, and I took those off just because it'd been a long time since I'd had them on, and I wanted to take them off, and I wanted to just have my nails heal. And like, my thumb is just still all butchered up, but they're doing way better, way, way better. And I have been working hard with them, and they're growing, and they're getting a lot more like hard, I don't know what the word is, but yeah, this stuff keeps peeling up. But I will put some new name brand, whatever brand that is, Jamberry nails on sometime, or at least nail on. Although I think I'm going to try the French manicure. I think I will order that one and try that soon because I really just like that look. And one of my friends said that she wears Jamberry nails, and I saw like a commercial, and she said that she can get 2 or 3 weeks out of them, which is pretty phenomenal. And I guess they have some new gel system that is supposed to be really good too. And I need to take better care of mine in the way that I like polish them and buff them out and all of that, because mine could look a lot whiter, I have a feeling. I don't know. They're not horrible. They're not ugly, but they're not pretty. They're way prettier with acrylics on, which is why I used to always wear them, but there gets to a point sometimes you just gotta change. And I was also kind of, in a way, not in a way, but I was kind of punishing myself because I was regretting, or not regretting, I was begrudging myself. That's not even the word. I don't know what I'm saying. I was not being nice to myself about going. I was feeling like it was a chore. And I thought, you know what, if you can't enjoy this, I mean, it's a treat to get your nails done. And if I can't appreciate it, then I don't deserve it. So that's kind of where I was with that. Probably weird to some of you, but what can I say? That's me. This says Happy Mail. I thought this was cute. I'm going to mail some Happy Mail. Hopefully Friday. So I'll put that down. And then this was just a box that I thought I could put somewhere because it's just a plain green box. I'll put it here. And this one I thought was kind of cute. I don't know if I'll put this on or not. I think I'll pass on that. And this one says, the first 5 days after the weekend are always the hardest, which I think is hilarious. And I'm going to put that over here. Looks like I saved a spot just for it, even though I didn't. Alright, so here is my weekly view so far, and I think that's really cute. And now I'm just going to put some stuff down, and I've already peeled off most of these things. So trash day is Tuesday to Wednesday, and my husband needs to take that out. Oh, and before I get too far, let's go ahead and put the washi down so I won't forget to do that. So my son has a game on Saturday. Oh, and I have helmet washi. I want to use that instead. I just got this. And I can't use very much of it because I put the little thing there, but that's okay. So helmet washi and a little piece of tiger washi. Because we are the tigers. And I need to decorate it with a little bit of sprinkle washi on that day. Because, like I said, that's my daddy's birthday. And I like this green sprinkle washi, and I have pink sprinkle washi also. So I'm going to do the green sprinkle. Looks like it starts there, but I guess not. I'm going to do the green sprinkle on this day because this is my dad's birthday. I think I'll just try to stick at the end. My dad would be so proud of my kids. I know he is watching over them. My mom too. They wanted to be grandparents so badly. And they both were before they passed. Just not for as long as we'd all hoped. Oh, the 25th is Aunt Deb's birthday. I'll put this one down here. I think we're going to go to dinner with her. My husband said he wanted to treat them to this place called Toscano's. It's a Brazilian restaurant, Brazilian steakhouse. We have another one called Fogo de Chao, which is phenomenal. That one's downtown. And Toscano's is a lot less expensive, and it's not as nice, but it's really, really good. I'm taking another drink. I also have this. Oh, and I have this. Cupcake washi. I think I'll use this one because it's thinner. So we'll put some cupcake washi. with the sprinkle washi. So all that washi is done. Football. I need to do some ballet washi on Monday. And Wednesday. And I should do it on Friday, but because it's a birthday, I think I'm going to pass. My daughter does dance at that game. I don't know. I can't do that. I'll put some on there. She dances at this game, but I don't think we're going to be able to go. Okay, and then that's that for the washi. So then now, I think that's that for washi. I was thinking of putting some red around here to mark the homecoming, so I think I might still do that. I think I'll put it around this guy. And I will just make him a bigger box. And then I can write in this little turtle thing, homecoming, and whatever details I know about it. I don't even know if the tickets have gone on sale. Very cool, very cool. So that will mark homecoming. Okay, and then I have this little football guy. And I have this little glass of wine to go here on this washi for Deb's birthday. Oh, I have my weekend banner. I took all of this stuff off so that I could try to be a little more prepared. So hopefully this works. The bad thing is I really don't know where I got any of this stuff. But the good thing on that is that I usually don't know anyway, so it doesn't really matter too much. And I need to do my nails on Monday and Wednesday and Friday. And I need to do laundry on the weekend, which probably will be Sunday because, like I've said, James Dean days. Oh, I need to put that on that one. I have a cute red bow tie, which is, I want to put that here to mark that it's homecoming. Oh, I don't like it there. It looks like the football player's wearing it. I think I'll do it up here like I was going to start. But then I didn't like how this didn't cover that, so I thought that I would try to cover it up, so that's where I was going with that, in case you guys wanted to follow me. And then I'm gonna put date night here because hopefully we will have a date night, even if it's a double date night with his aunt. I need to mail these packages, so I'm going to put this little mail guy. My dad's birthday, I'm marking with this blue cupcake, even though there's cupcakes here. Maybe I'll just put it right there. And TV, I don't know when I'm going to watch TV. I think I'll put it here. I don't know if I'll watch TV that day or not, but I do need to change the bed linen, so I'm going to put that here. And I need to do laundry. Oh, I guess this is the dishwasher. I'm going to put the dishwasher over here because I usually run it in the middle of the week at least once. Oh no, that is the laundry. Oh well, here's the dishwasher. I'll put him here too. I'll just try to get some stuff done that day. And the vacuum cleaner, I'm going to put him over here. And then let's see what else I have up here. I have my makeup brushes. I need to clean those. I'd like to do a bath with a mask. And I'm going to put that on Friday. Because that's James Dean Days. Let me think on this. I'm going to put this on Thursday. And I know I keep saying James Dean Days, and I wonder if you guys even know what that is. Because I did not before my husband. And James Dean is an actor that's old, and he's passed away a long time ago. And you guys may or may not have heard of him, Rebel Without a Cause or something. I don't really know exactly what he did, but I know he was a star, like a movie star, and he died in a car accident. And he is from a place in Indiana, Fairmount. And, ooh, I think that's right. And he, oh, he usually has Monday and Tuesday time to do it then, so I'm going to put this over here. He has a museum in Fairmount, and he also has a, it's like a, oh, what do you call them? Like a fall festival. And it's just called James Dean Days, and there's lots of really good food, and there is lots of fun, and there is vendors selling stuff, and there's, what is there? Oops, there's another trash one I got out too. There's, oh goodness, what am I trying to think of? Oh, I will have gotten some already, so I'll put this on this day. Cars, like old cars, like it's a car show. And my husband loves the car shows, so I need to get dog food and cat food pretty badly. So I should probably put this on this week so I won't forget to do that. And actually, I had Chinese food, so I need to put this down. And dog food, I think I'll get some this weekend. And I need to mail I need to order the Etsy stuff on this day. Okay, and then I thought this was cute. It's just a little frog. I thought it went well with the purple theme. So, oops. Okay, I think that that's about it with all of those things. So then now I have other things to do. So let's see. It is camel for hump day. And I don't know why I think that's so funny, but I do. So I am just putting him on the hump day. And I'm almost at an hour already. I'm trying to hurry. I'm trying to hurry. I'm trying to hurry. Blog, which I totally ignore. I'm just going to put it over here because I really don't do much with it and I need to someday. So I will just put it there. So hopefully I won't forget someday. And I want to post my spread the week or whatever, spread them wide or whatever. I need to do that on Sunday. And then I need to do it on Wednesday, even though I'm usually a Monday, Thursday person. I need to try to remember to switch that. And YouTube, I will put a video up on Monday and Wednesday and Friday. And Sunday. And I have these boxes, but I don't think I need them. And some meal plan and stickers. Let's put some of these down here. I just thought these were really cute. You could write down what you ate that day or whatever. So I'm going to do green and pink. Green, pink, green, pink, green. Okay, I'm just going to not do those, and then I'll do pink here. And pink here, and then I'll leave the other ones blank because I think I'm going out that day, or this day. And then it's the weekend, and I don't really plan a whole lot. I mean, I do a little bit, but, and I just have a lot to pray about this week, and I got these from Happy Planning Designs, and I thought these were really cute. This is in my grab bag, so I'm going to put this down just so that I won't forget to thank God for all my blessings and to pray for the things that I feel like I need to pray for. And I thought these were cute for homecoming, so I'm going to use some of these, not all of them, but some of them. Let's see, I'll put a red rose there. And this top hat, this is really for New Year's. And these music notes. I asked my son if he was nervous about dancing, and he said, yeah, a little. And I said, well, do you want me to show you my moves? And he said, no. Whatever. Young man. I can boogaloo with the best of them. I'm honestly just proud that he asked somebody to go. I knew he would. He's kind of one of those social butterfly kind of people. I don't know where he gets it, because I am definitely more of an introvert, but I think I used to be more of an extrovert. I think just in my old age, I've gotten more of an introvert. And I know I'm not old, I'm just teasing. I mean, 21 isn't old, right? I hope you guys can hear me. I feel like I'm talking kind of low, and I don't really know why. I don't know why. So that's cute. That's for homecoming. And I'm going to put a tassel there too. And I think I'll do this green and pink and gold one. So I'll put a tassel here for my dad's birthday and for homecoming, but I think I'll put it here. It will mark both. And then here's some cute cupcakes that I will use for my aunt's birthday. Actually, it's Dennis's aunt's, but whatever. I'm claiming her. I like her. And I think I'll use one of these heart check-em boxes over here. And I think I'll save the rest. Then I have these. I think that what I have, I'll just use what I have. Enough. And then I have some more boxes, and I have this game thing, which I guess I can use one of these. I'll put it here. Then I have these, which I like, and I need to use a couple of these because I know I need to do a video. My daughter wants me to do another plan with me video, or a day in the life video, which I haven't even thought about for a while, but those were, that was fun to make, so I might do another one of those coming up sometime before the end of the year. I think that's all I'll do for now. So let's see how that looks. Do I need any more of those little filming guys? I don't think so. Okay, so now I'm going to, I think I will use pink and let's see. Well, let's go ahead and mark this. So the 21st through the 27th. And I don't want it to shine through. I'm going to put day in the life. It's kind of fun to do it on a weekday or week. Yeah, a weekday, because then you kind of get, you know, the real working, what people do, what I do. It's real. And then I'm going to put here, dinner with Aunt Debbie and Uncle Dan. Debbie and Dan. And I need to write homecoming here. I'm trying to write it nice. I kind of don't like it in that pink fluorescent. I think I might write over it in red. And then I'll take the black. And then I will put Dad's birthday. And I will put Deb's birthday, but I think I'll do that in a Sharpie. And then I think I'm also going to write 6 to 9 on her dance days. And then I need to write that he's at Brownsburg, but I don't want to put it in that because I don't want it to go through. So let's do it in just this blue color. Graham versus Brownsburg. Ten a.m. Oh, and I also need to pick up the corsage. Yeah, I'm gonna write this in this black because I'm not a big fan of the pink, which is weird because I love pink, but that's like a fluorescent pink and it just doesn't do it for me. So I'm going to write this again. Maybe I should have written it in the green, but dinner with Aunt Deb and Uncle Dan. Then there's homecoming. I need to pick up corsage. So I just wrote P-U corsage. And I'm going to make it so the turtle is saying that. And I think I will outline the turtle a little bit. There we go. And I need to write James Dean Days. Oh, and I know I have some cute food stickers. I need to pull those out and put some cute food stickers on here for James Dean Days, because, man, they have some good food. It's like fair food, and I didn't go to the fair this year, so I need myself an elephant ear. And I think that's all that I have going on this week. I don't have a ton going on, clearly. And then when I'm preparing to do my next week's plan with me, oh, I know I had a plan with me. Here it is. I knew I had a plan with me, guy. I think I'm going to put this here. When I do next week's plan with me, I'm going to be going to Dallas. So I need to do 2 weeks, I think, in a row. I'm not exactly sure how I'm going to do that yet, because I need to do... yeah, I think I'll do 2 weeks in a row, because I need to do the birthday week, my son's birthday week, and then I also need to do the Dallas week. And I think that how I'll do it, I don't think I'm going to take my planner with me to Dallas, but I might just take the pages so that I'm taking just this instead of my big planner. I think that's what I might do. So, I'll put game here. And I think that that's it for now. So thank you very much for watching. I hope this wasn't too awfully boring for you or too long. I know that sometimes I can get wordy, and I'm doing it again. So I will stop, but thank you so much for watching. If you did like this, please give me a thumbs up and consider subscribing. I'd love to have you as a subscriber. I try to do a plan with me every week, and actually I do a plan with me every week. I have done it for the last several, well, this whole year, actually. And also I don't know what I was going to say. I post videos on Monday, Wednesday, Friday, and then my plan with me on Sundays is usually how it goes. So thanks a bunch for watching, and I hope you subscribe, and I will talk to you soon. Happy planning!